Sup guys and gals, welcome to my channel, Killawulf here, and today I'm back with another episode of My Wolfy World. Now, obviously, if you weren't here for the last episode and don't know what I'm doing here, this is my series where I build all the crazy builds I want to. Now, this house here is not an example of how good I am at building, because to be honest, this is terrible. I'm sorry that the torches are still as well. I've had to turn off my animations just to make it that less laggy, because I don't know why, but this texture pack has decided to become laggy all of a sudden. I have no idea why. What the hell is my mouse doing? Anyway, so today, what we are going to be doing is we are going to be building a tavern. Well, I say a tavern, I mean an inn. And obviously, because this is season one, I will be building a medieval build. Now, I'm tempted to change my texture pack to the default one. I think I might, because if I have to keep changing texture packs throughout this entire series, it's not going to look that good, is it? I might have to get a special texture pack that changes the glass and makes it clear. I might do that myself. Alright, so here we go. We're back. I've changed the texture pack to the default one. My armor is really, really bright. Look at it compared to the rest of this landscape. I've also got to change that gravel, because the gravel was good before in the other texture pack because it had brown in it, but I'm going to have to change it to coarse dirt now because that matches it in the default texture pack. But I think these spruce fences match. Oh, for God's sake, my camera just keeps whipping around. So, obviously, first things first, I'm going to have to get my resources from the room in here. Now, it's not in that chest. Okay, that's a wall. That is cobblestone. I don't need that yet. I will need it though. Here it is. Oh, this is going to annoy me. There we go. So we've got all the spruce we need. Do I want to use stone brick? Yeah, maybe. Can I? Oh god. My mouse is so annoying. You know, I think I might use cobblestone like I did before. This is only temporary storage, this chest, for these bits, but because those won't be in there. I just haven't set up a chest for them. Let's empty out our inventory. Oh, for God's sake. No, there. Right. Redstone. Where can I put my stuff? This is my random chest. Why haven't I been putting it in here? Who cares? Right, sticks can go in there. I'll need that. String. I'll need the cobblestone. I'll need you. Don't need any arrows. Actually, no. I'll keep a stack. Sugarcane don't need. Redstone is in my chest over here. Okay, thank you, game. That's the wrong one. Alright, there we go. These pants I do not need. There we go. Alright, what else am I not gonna need? I will need those. I can't remember how many windows I have though, so there's a chance I might have to come back in and get that, or get all of these down here. We need to put our buckets in the chest. I need to merge these. How much did it say these were again? Oh wait, wasn't it me trying? Oh yeah, yeah, that's not gonna happen. What about you and you? That other way around then. Yeah, that's too expensive. You're clever, game. Definitely. These two terrible bows are apparently more expensive than this. Alright, you know what's going to happen to these bows because I can't use them? They're going to go over here. Bye, bye, and bye. There we go. Alright, I've got everything I need here, I think. Oh wait, no, I'm going to need that. I also need my cobblestone fences from in here. In here. We don't need slabs. I will need some more cobblestone though. The moment you have like hardly any cobblestone is when you have to start to worry. It means you've like not been mining whatsoever, and I haven't. What am I looking for? Oh, I forgot. I didn't realize I had 3 diamonds in there. Where's my pick? I had a pickaxe. Where has it gone? Did I not have a diamond pickaxe or something? I didn't realize that. I've got a stone pickaxe instead. I think it'd be better at the moment for me to make an iron one because I've got a load more iron. Oh wait. I will have a load more iron at some point. Maybe I might make an iron golem farm. I don't know when, but it'll have to be in a bit. Because I'm going to need this pick. I don't want a stupid slow stone one. Alright, I'm also going to need an axe, so I need some more iron. There we go. That's not 3. There we go. I'm going to have to go on a hunt for iron, because I don't have a lot of it. You'd think that would be the one thing I have loads of. I can see I have an enchanted apple in there, but it is... How many nether warts do I have? Wow. That's a lot more than my other world. Mainly because I had to reset it, but because it deleted itself. What am I? It's my extreme hardcore survival world that I had to reset because my bloody game's stupid and like decided to delete it. I don't need redstone torches. I don't need you. Where's... I might need the iron shovel. Do I not have any more sticks in this chest? No, I don't. I might have some okay, that's a roof. Nope. Okay. Looks like we're gonna have to use a bit of spruce to make some sticks. There we go, and... There we go. Right. So, we are going to put the sticks in there. Okay, that's not the way I wanted to go. Oh, it's night time. Okay, thank you, game. Alright, let's just, don't want any creepers by us. There we go. Dead. Okay, stop spazzing out. Why is this mouse spazzing out? It shouldn't be happening that often. It never does this normally. Oh, I need a drink. Oh, that's good. Whoa. No, you blew up my house. But my path. You stupid. Why? Why you do this to me? Let's use the gravel, because... For God's sake, why does this hole have to be so deep? Let me out. Alright, there we go. You're lucky I bloody have like tons and tons of blooming. Oh, thank you, mouse. Thank you for spazzing me out again. Oh my god. I cannot wait till I get a new mouse and a new computer because, I mean, also my trackpad is messing this up as well. My mouse doesn't help by spinning me around constantly. I'm not a bloody ballerina. Alright, let's try and see. Is anything over here? Because I wanted to build up here. Nothing is over here at the moment. Okay. Alright, I think we can get into the time lapse then. Because first things first, we are going to build the frame. Let's go. Thank you. Alright guys, here we are, back. The time lapse is over. It's taken an hour and 28 minutes, or less, I don't know, to do this. Some of it was me trying to change game modes and all that sort of stuff, so I can go ahead and do this. So I can fly around and add in a bit of a montage and stuff like that of everything outside of my first person view. Now, I am actually really happy with this build so far. I like that I've added block variation into the blocks at the bottom, but throughout that thing I've probably added a few messages saying like, make sure you tell Mojang to add this message, because for some reason I do not understand. Oh, I don't have it on me. It's just like, I don't understand the crafting recipe for this, because why can't you craft, once you've made a glass pane, why can't you dye it when it's already there? Because otherwise you're just going to end up with, like, chests filled with, like, stuff that you've used for previous builds, but then you decided you didn't want that glass anymore. Now, it's kind of annoying, isn't it? I wanted to try and have light grey glass, because in most inns and stuff like that back then, the glass was kind of foggy, and this is medieval times, so yeah. You can kind of see it's got a bit of moss and there's all that sort of stuff on it, and the cobblestone at the bottom. That's mainly because in medieval times, all these kind of places weren't that very nice. You usually find like inns and all that sort of stuff in the slummy areas. Now obviously they're not as bad as the houses that you get around them, because those can be 10 times worse. Now obviously medieval times they mainly constructed things out of wood and stone, and they did use glass for windows, but that was something. They also tended to have massive castles and stuff around, but that's something that everything has. Like, most times in the olden days had castles. I don't know why I say most times in the olden days. But you can tell that so far I've gotten the basic shape of it out, and I've done the bar. Now you're like, you may be like, what are all these stairs and these weird pressure plate things around, if you've never seen this technique before? These weird things around, these pressure plates on fences, are actually tables. So this is an old design you can do. Now, there are other things like pistons and snow, probably do it with, I think, carpet as well. I don't have any carpet at the moment, but once I get wool up, I will change these out for a brown carpet. Because they had wooden tables back then, so they're not exactly going to have some weird fancy thing in a bar. An inn, which has a tavern at the bottom and the bedrooms upstairs. And this right here is the counter. I don't know if you guessed that, but you can go in here. The barman will be behind here. This is a drink glass, because this is the only thing I'm capable of doing. And all of these chests would have... Okay, thank you, camera. All of these chests would have potions in, all that sort of stuff, which would symbolize the drinks of this place, because this will be my potion storing thing. Now, I've also made a birch staircase right here to go up to the next floor, which will have all the rooms and stuff that the people sleep in. And because this is an inn, the rooms aren't going to be that good. They're going to be kind of gloomy, kind of rubbish, and you'll always hear people downstairs going like, "Whoa, yeah, you want a battle," or something like that. Or they'll just be like partying because they're all drunk and stuff, listening to the lute and all that sort of stuff, but yeah. And obviously these birch stairs here, these are the bar stools. So you've got the ones that are turned to the side, you've got the ones facing normally. And the reason why there are some turned to the side, and some tables that have missing chairs and stuff, is because whenever you go to a bar, you never see all the chairs. Whenever you see like a tavern or stuff, the chairs aren't laid out perfectly because people are drunk, they run around, they move chairs about, they want to move chairs to sit with their friends. And the tables aren't always the same, because you have the tables that are against the wall, the tables that are bigger, the tables that are just one table, and you have this counter here where people sit and just buy their drinks straight off and talk to the barman. Now, obviously I haven't finished everything yet, but I will finish it in the next video. I have to plan a roof design, because this is as far as I've gotten. Down there was actually something I made up just now. That's a new kind of design point for me. I haven't tried this before, but I think it looks really cool. Once these are brown carpets, it'll look a lot better. And also, once up here has been done and I've collected a load more resources, it should be fine. But I was unable to collect any resources like Saturday and Sunday, which is when I usually do that sort of stuff. Mainly because my extreme hardcore survival world deleting itself. Now because of that, I think it got corrupted or something, but because of that I had to get everything back together, build a new house, and all that sort of stuff. I did have a custom world like this one was, but in that one, not only did I have double the amount of dungeons, I also increased the count for diamonds in the extreme hardcore survival world just so I could get back at how I was doing, and it turned out I have more diamonds than I'll ever need in my life. Diamonds are the thing that I have the most of, because I have like multiple stacks of them, I did have multiple stacks. Now I have a stack, because I use them to make armor and all that sort of stuff, and I don't know what happened to the rest. They went somewhere. Actually, no, I think I do have multiple stacks of diamonds, because I swear I remember seeing them in there. I also made a jukebox of them in that world. But, because I found loads of dungeons with Cat and 13 in it, and I literally just sat there and listened to Cat. Because then I really wanted to listen to my other stuff. Why did I go in the cow farm? Can I get out? Yeah, I can. Right, where's that? There's the fence. But what I really want to do is in the future, when I get the roof on, I want to add like leaves trickling down, a little bit of greenery right here, add the pathway in, add some custom trees around. Now obviously, because it's not a fantasy build and it is a medieval build, buildings will be compacted together and stuff. So sometimes I'll have to take down trees and stuff like that, and obviously because this is a tavern, an inn, not many people are going to be cramped up against this. The houses tend to be a bit further away from the inn, and houses always seem to be bunched up together only if they're houses. Now yes, shops can be bunched up together, but shops don't bunch up with the houses. Also, if you have a forge, they can sometimes be bunched up against the house, the other shops, but other times they can be on their own. The tavern, on the other hand, is never bunched up with anything, because the top of the tavern always extends out on all the sides to give it more room at the top. What? I said a tavern? Why do I keep saying tavern? It's an inn. It's not called a tavern. Tavern's just literally like in there, and that bit down there. Actually, no, yeah, that's a tavern. So the tavern is pretty much the bottom floor, the inn area is the top floor pretty much, but altogether it's an inn. I could make another little tavern, but taverns are kind of like generally smaller, and they're not like this build where I can make it look beautiful and stuff. But the main reason for me building it, making the tavern first, is because I want to get into potion brewing and storing all my potions in here. So then I can go ahead and just like, oh, I need a potion of swiftness while I'm trying to build this thing. Let's go grab it. This world will hopefully last a while. It's also coming up to my birthday soon, meaning I'll be able to get a computer soon, and hopefully the real version of Minecraft. Fingers crossed. Not double-crossed, otherwise it'll never happen. But, if I can, get my, big, awesome computer, then I'll be able to, obviously, have better mouse, have better keyboard that isn't loud and clunky. You won't hear the constant whirring of my computer in the background, which kind of makes everything bad. And also, I will have to have a mic as well, because it won't be something that's installed into a laptop, because my laptop has that. Now, there is the chance that I might use my laptop to render videos, but I'm not quite sure, because I think rendering a video on my laptop would take forever. So I might just use my laptop for me getting an alternate, when I get an alternate account, I can just go on and just like use that build, and I can start doing things like Shin does, where, from the Yogscast, if you haven't heard of him, I'm pretty sure you would have, where he has like a thing on the outside flying around, and he's like in there building. I want to kind of do that, but except I'll be building on my laptop, and keeping, instead of having to constantly change the recording thing, I can set the spectator mode with my big computer, and just sit it there, move around, and all that sort of stuff, and it'll make my time lapses 10 times better, hopefully. Now obviously I kind of want to keep the path design I have here, except I need to change these out for coarse dirt so they match this more, and obviously that sort of stuff. I've also got to reconfigure this because it's grass. Also, I need to try and make a proper barn for cows and stuff. I need a farm. I'm thinking the farm should be over in that area, away from where the main medieval village will be. Now, the inn and stuff will be kind of on the outskirts of the medieval village. I'm thinking of pushing it back that way. And obviously I will build a fantasy one at some point, which means things will be a lot more spaced out, things will be a lot more beautiful. Not everything will look dingy and dark and gloomy and stuff, and musty. It'll kind of look a lot more kind of peaceful, and seems like everyone in the world is the exact same as each other compared to the actual real life scenario. But I think that'll be pretty cool. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. It's my first time lapse in my series, and it's only the second episode. So be prepared for more builds like this, and also be prepared for when I get the roof, and also finish the in rooms up the top floor. Now, also, I would like it if you guys could also give me another kind of build I can do in this world, after I finished the inn. And you can always give one to me today. We'll be perfectly fine with taking your comment and saving it for another video. But obviously, next episode, I will have to finish the roof and the inn bit on the inside. So that will be the main goal for the next episode. But doesn't mean that I won't build things you say. Now, you can also give me things that you can think of in the real world right now that are modern day, and I will try and convert them into medieval. So things like cinemas, or if you call them theatres or stuff, will probably end up being like, what are they called? They're called theatres, aren't they? Yeah, they're just theatres and stuff like that, where you can sit there, watch people do plays and everything. And things like bars, obviously, is what the inn is, but it'll be a tavern only. Tons of stuff like that. Obviously, factories, that's something I cannot do, because factories were never in the medieval times. Everything was manual labor, there were no factories. There was no need. Now, there was the forge and the blacksmith. They would constantly go to going, hey, we need new swords and all that sort of stuff. So if you say a factory, I'm instantly just going to build a forge, and you're not going to get something different. I'm not going to build multiple forges. But obviously, I will have to build two forges in this world. A forge that will be within the city for the public, and also a forge in the barracks for where the military people go in the castle. But yes, I said castle. I'm gonna build a castle that will be where I live instead of this shack over there. But anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I shall see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.